Well, hey there, Cancer. Welcome to this Twin Flame Tower love reading. My name's Sophia. Welcome back or welcome if you're new. Let's jump straight in, see what's happening with you. Okay, what's going on? Let's see. So, could have been an off, I'm seeing, picking up a kind of a, and I'll go into that, the first card, Wheel of Fortune. So, I'm seeing if it's actually, because I feel it, normally the Wheel of Fortune, and what I state is a reader, which is a will. So a will goes forward, it goes back, or it stays still. I'm feeling it's staying still due to the other cards. And it's like, you see the monkey at the top of the will. It's like, go within and stop reacting with your reptilian or your monkey mind to this argument. This is who this resonates with. It's even got, that's represented of the waxing crescent moon, full moon, which is crowned on the High Priestess. The High Priestess goes within. This is showing you that instead of reacting, go within, as above, so below, as within, so without. Meaning that if you're reacting or being negative to your person, it's going to come back to you because you two are aligned as one, because of that's what twin flames are about. So there's something here that I'm feeling that it's not staying still because you're not understanding your world, your universe, you in reverse. This is what we're here to do, to teach others. I'm going to hopefully do a video about that as well on Saturday. Let's see about the roles of the twin flame or what the feminine are supposed to do. One of those is to know the laws of the planet and how you manifest and how you get your desires. And this is like saying that it's all about going within, you in reverse, universe, your world, your wants, your desires. So, but I'm feeling like, I said it's not moving forward due to the other cards. And it's like, and I state again, the monkey mind here on top of the wheel, and it's closing your eyes. Because the next one, it's like, is your person stuck? Eight of Swords. Other tarot readers will say Eight of Swords is they're stuck, but they can move through it and it's all in their head. I couldn't give a shit what them lot say. They don't understand tarot for a start. My point is that whatever situation over there, I don't care. There's like loads of things, of reasons why your person may stay in a situation over there. Belief systems, traditions, comfort, don't want to come out of the box. Stuff that you don't want to do. If they wasn't stuck in their role over there and it was easy, then I would have lots of people in union by now if everyone followed what people think they should do. It's easy to say you're stuck, but to do it yourself, because you are stuck, because this reading here, you're not doing stuff that is making you progress into union of self. So it's a perfect reflection because these two cards are showing how you're aligned. He's your this is the first card, the monkey mind. This isn't going forward because you're not going within. And this person is blinded as well. So it's like you're both. It's not you're both not going in. Your person over there is your teacher. He is showing you, look, go within. What I'm in my belief systems, that represents third eye, that represents as above, so below, as within, so without. That is connected to the heart chakra. I am tied over here. He is stubborn like a bull. Stubborn is Taurus, so I'm stubborn, but I can still feel you with the flames in the background. Don't think this is like deception with the Five of Swords here. And there's heartbreak, yes, but this is the masculine. So he gets it as well, because most of you think that they don't get heartbreak, it's just you. No, they have it as well. They just don't react to it or no, they don't express it, most of them hide it, masculine, right? So there's a situation which you're, there could have been an off due to the situation, let's say third party that your person is in over there, and you reacted and they, he charged back at you. So there's an argument. So it's not moving forward. And I repeat, because you are not going within, they are in their role as perfection over there to teach you to go within, not to try to change this. This is to do with something to do with the money, not your money, your person's money, to do with, that's like leaves here. So he could spend his money on drugs, alcohol, a secret, or you have a knowing of that he's spending his money on, it could be on a mortgage, because that looks like a secret garden to me. Hold on. I've got to get this angle here because it looks dark when I do it. See, look, it looks like a secret garden in a forest. So he could like a house. So he could spend all his money on the house, the mortgage. It's, and this is the squirrel. The squirrel in this deck to me is about guidance. Go within. There's two cards here about go within, tap into yourself and understand this situation and why your person is spending all his money on whatever they're spending it on, or why they spend it on addictions. There's always a reason. Always a reason about it. I'm creating a massive program about all this belief systems, traditions and stuff like that. So it's like, this is someone who's new to this channel. And if you're not new and you've got my program, you're not doing the work. This is what I'm picking. Hence why I can give money back guarantee. Because I can pick up if there's work done or not for my program. My program makes you feel 100% better and in union with self. Absolutely. 100%. If you have the program, you're not working on yourself. Like I say, that's why I can say this is new. Because this is someone who's still looking at their person. Oh, you're over there. You're with your third party. You're still doing drugs. Working all hours of the day. La, la, la. There's something like that here. Underneath the Wheel of Fortune is like, this card is, underneath the Wheel of Fortune is, this guy's kind of meditating. Now, I will think this is you about balancing out your masculine. This is reacting to your person. This is about going within. Look, Four of Cups in traditional decks is that guy leaning against the tree. Tree is rooted. Rooted belief systems. With Three Cups, the third party, which I'm saying here, he, in front of him, and One Cup from the sky, obviously 5D, higher consciousness, you're the high priestess, you. And people say, oh, bothering on the third party, not seeing your cup. If four cups are in the picture or in the tarot, that he can see the fucking cups. If it's just three cups, he can only see three. If it's two cups, he can see two. It's not like you can't see it. It's in the fucking card. People don't know how to read tarot. It just means he doesn't know what to do. He's leaning against the tree. He's leaning against his belief systems, his traditions, his upbringing. And his upbringing is not to connect upstairs with the emotional plane, because we are the emotional plane, because the hand of cup that's coming out is the emotional plane. Connect with spirituality. That's not their contract. That's our contract as a twin flame. In this deck, the fourth cups is like, you go within, you feel your person. Look, hands feel things, because then he feels you, because the twin, look, that flame, how can he not feel that? This is Eight of Swords, stuck in mental conflict situations and stubborn, but that flame, can he not feel that? So this is the advice. Stop reacting with your monkey mind, because it's not going forward. Go within, and that will stretch out the caps. It will balance. Look, it's equally balanced, and fill your person. So this reading, like I said, is for someone new, because this Four of Cups and this meditation card is a start. Hermit is a is what you're supposed to do. It's meditation, then the Hanged Man, then the Hermit card. This is the beginning. is telling you to go within. And once again, look, he will come, he will transfer from one tree of life, one belief system, traditions, to his own tradition, religion, whatever. And the crab hair, which is a cardinal sign, which is the leader. So he will lead his own thoughts process, because it's the cardinals on his head, his brain, his mind. So this is someone who needs to understand oneself of the twin flame journey, about going within. Underneath the Eight of Swords, the stuck. He's stuck because, like I state, they don't know how to balance it out. It's not that they don't see the cut, they don't understand it. What happens is they don't want to emotionally invest in you because of, if they tell, I damn well know from where I am, doing tarot readings and stuff and channeling from 5D. If they said, yeah, I love you and I want to come live with you, well, when? Oh, can we book the wedding? And can I get my white dress? I've got an appointment for us to have a fitting. Do you like this venue? That will happen. And then you will be a soulmate. So they stay over in this stuckness because of you. I'll repeat that, because of you, because you're not in your role. Their role is to be this, so you go within. They are your teachers. If this wheel isn't moving forward and staying still or going backwards, it's because you are not doing the work. They will stay over there, and that is their role, to try to, you know, is try to get a balance. Your person doesn't know how to balance it out. When it is aligned, it's an equal balance. And I don't give a shit if the children is 6 or 60 years old. Children to the masculine come first. That's it. When you start working on yourself, it becomes an equal balance between you and the children. If you're like, oh, he's with the children, he's giving everything to the children, you have an issue with that. This is their contract for you to work out why. Probably because you felt less than as a child. So you want someone to give you more. That's your role. This is what they teach you. Stop worrying about what he's doing over there. Work on yourself. Then it becomes an equal balance. That's how it is. You work on your pentacles, which is mission. Look, emotionally fulfill yourself and work on mission with that pentacle here. Follow your guidance. Your guidance. He's still there. That's an equal share. It comes an equal share. This is Six of Pentacles. So, but that's for you when you start off doing that. Start. This is a start. Underneath these pentacles here, massive pentacle, Ace of Pentacles, is this Knight of Cups. I like this card. I know it's not a great card, but this is them once again in their classic role as a twin flame. 100% totally shielded. Right, but look at him holding the cup. I am emotionally connected to you. I am a twin flame with the feather. He's riding the fish, which this is the moon, the crescent moon, the waxing moon. Once again, that's the symbolism, that's the crown on the high priestess. The high priestess goes with him. So he's, the high priestess is the moon. This is the moon. He's riding the fish, Pisces. Pisces is the moon. It's like, I'm connected to you. I'm riding the fucking fish. But I won't remove this shield until you get your probe, what you're supposed to do, your contract. Literally not in the words of that, but that is how the contract's supposed to be. But this isn't a great situation for your person. This is early. So there could be arguments. Like I say, this last card here is, this person looks pissed off, charging in and attacking you because you're attacking him about his, him or her, about his or her situation over there. That's what's happening here. You're attacking him about what's going on. I heard some noises in the background. So he's charging back at you, once again, stubborn in his way. I don't even know what that is, but I'll just say it's a bull. Moving forward, don't want those stupid comments about you don't know what it is. Just shut up. I can't be dealing with that. Twin flames are not here to put thumbs down and stupid ass comments. That's nowhere's near union. I can't believe it when they get a thumbs down, because you don't like what someone said that's not resonated to you. and you're not even paid for it. It's ridiculous. It's nowhere near union, most people. It's unreal. I don't understand it. Stupidity. So this person, that matter of everyone on YouTube is tiptoeing around the people that watch when they upload the video for free. This is mindset or stupidity. But this is not wake. This is someone who's just watching those videos and thinking naively. It's not even naive. You know. Tarot ain't getting you with your person. Because if it was, wouldn't there be millions in union by now? This is someone's not investing. They might invest on an extended read. But once again, does that get people in union? You need to buy my program. There is no one, and I repeat, no one on YouTube that guarantees their program, let alone a tarot reading. No one. And I channel from 5D. No one. So this is what pisses me off. I don't understand how no one buys my program. Well, not everyone. Because of what is your loss? Because I guarantee it. Plus, once you work on self, you get mission. And then I say, sell my program. No catch. So this is someone who's expecting to get your person to be a soulmate. 100% for this reading, which you're a twin flame. Do the work. Do the work. We're not here as angelic beings to go and bitch and moan and argue with your person. We are here as the high priestess to go within. The high priestess in some decks doesn't even have a fucking face. No face, no mouth, no hearing, no talking. She goes within. We are the high priestess in the tarot that escalate to the magician card, the enlightened one, which is the top of the Kabbalistic tree of life. That is what we are here for. Not to go to your person, you're stuck over there, blah, blah, blah. You're spending all your money on drugs. I don't understand how that could literally affect you. That's affecting him or her. How does that affect you? If my person's over there getting stoned, doing drugs or whatever, how does that affect me doing this today? This is what people don't understand. This is what this person don't understand. Oh, you spend all your money. That's about selfishly wanting your person to stop spending money on kids, stop masking up, stop spending it on the mortgage on whatever. I can't even see third party here. This is just stuff that you just want your person to make you happy. Yeah. Did Jesus do that? Come down and look for someone and tell that dictate to him to do it. And I'm not even religious, but I know that he didn't do that. He went on Facebook. He didn't take coupled pictures with his person. Did he even have someone? That's how much I don't know about religion. I don't know jack shit about it. That's why I was chosen. Don't give a shit if them lot moan about religion. Because I have no here or there about any religion. I believe in myself. So let's get some clarity. Someone needs some harsh lessons told here. Hence, once again, why I've been chosen. Too softly fluff out there. Ah, oh, dump them. That's what they say. Dump them. Yeah. And you pine for them for the rest of your life and in misery. Worry, look. You're worrying because you're not doing the work. This is Taurus. This is you're stubborn. So you're stubborn, your person's stubborn. How can that move forward if you're stubborn? Hence the Wheel of Fortune. This is representing of, look, that's what I'm saying here, look. The Taurus is about finances. So you're worried about your person spending all his money, and this one is representing, let me see if you can see that one here. That one represents Mercury. Mercury is obviously, people know it, Mercury retrograde. Mercury is about communication. Like I said, there's been an off. But Mercury is connected with Gemini. Gemini is the twins, the lover. This is your twin flame. So you need to learn how to communicate correctly because words matter, energy, frequency. If you are of a negative, which 99.9% on planet Earth are of a negative, then you speak negative, you attract more negative. It doesn't matter if you speak positive, to be honest. if you have negative within, you just speaking the words doesn't really affect the matter enough for it to align. You have to remove the negative, then speak positive words. So, but all you're doing is pushing this will, your universe, back, delaying it by speaking negative, you see. Speaking positive just keeps it staying still. Removing negativity makes the will go forward. Let me see what else. Third house, the Lover's card. It's mutable, air, yeah, words, thoughts. Let's have a look. Third house is to do with family. So you're listening to people telling you what to do. Oh, he's no good. He's over there. He don't contact you. He's not coming to see the family. Stupidness. What do they know about twin flame? You don't even know about twin flame. Mercury's also connected with Virgo. Virgo is connected with, like I said, deep hermit inner knowing. Not listening to people who don't know jack shit about twin flame, as you don't. And don't tell me you do, because if you do, this reading wouldn't be like this. You don't. And yeah, you might not think, oh, well, don't have a go at me. I've just come onto this page. This is how I am allowed to channel. Because you twin flames are not in union. So you lot need hard, tough love. So if you've come onto my channel, there's a reason for it. Divine timing, 5D, because you're listening to other fluff and it's not happening for you. So you've come onto a channel like mine that's saying, get your ass into union and know yourself as a twin flame. Go within with the Mercury. Stop worrying about, oh, my person's not doing nothing. It's nothing to do with your person. This is you. Take responsibility as your contract as a twin flame. You can't cut the cord. You know that. That's a bullshit. Cutting the cord. How can you cut the cord of energy? Tell me how you can cut energy. You can't. You are energetically aligned with your twin flame. Hence, you are here as a twin flame. So as I said, I'm going to do a video about why you're here, to know the laws of the planet. So how can you cut an imaginary cord? It's ridiculous. You need to understand who you truly are. I'm going to end this with a kipper. They're telling me to pull you into Taurus. What's Taurus? I should know Taurus. I'm a Taurus. I keep forgetting what the house is. It's not first house. It's Taurus is second house, I think. Yeah, money. I said that. How people perceive you. This person's worried about what other people think. That other people concern. Who's that? Oh, your dad telling you I'm concerned because you're with this person or blah, blah, blah. What's that? Oh, he's not coming to meet my dad. La, 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 la. This is three, look. Three of swords. Third party. But if you change the duality from the negative of the card to the positive, which what we're supposed to be as a tarot reader, to understand the laws and the planet and how to read tarot connected with the tree of life, and that's knowing oneself, the fool's journey jumps into the unknown because he doesn't know jack shit. Hence, you need to know tarot, which is the fool's journey. The fool card is in the hidden realms of the Kabbalah tree of life. Then you wouldn't worry about other people, because it's all about knowing yourself, not what others are concerned about your person. Then the three and the three add up together, become six. Six of wands is victory. This, changing the duality from someone else's concern, which is creating heartbreak for you, heartbreak to your person, to add it together as one. You two are one. So you lead, you're the light worker. Your person is the yang, the dark, like that. You lead, it goes on to him. He will see the light from this darkness. Not like other bullshit tower readers. Oh, let him come out. He can move out of the eight of swords. Bollocks. Light worker, you shed the light by knowing the laws of the planet as the energy you align within yourself, which you're connected to your twin flame, which makes him align. Then he'll move. Don't know your twin flame journey, this person, whoever I'm connecting with. So, as you can tell, well, I haven't even gone deep into this. So you can either book me, because like I said, 100% money back guarantee, and no one has asked me for money back. I've been on YouTube for a year and a half. Or check out my playlist. I have two, not one, but two to show you that I know my shit and get you into union. Twin flames are here to connect as a community, which I'm going to say on my channel on Saturday, as well as getting into union of self. and showing others how to do that successfully, but you are nowhere close. To do that, you need to connect with the others that are on my subscription list. Every week or two, I'm going to go through and tell you who to connect with. My sister is now done a channel. Please subscribe, like, share her channel. I don't care if she doesn't resonate with you. You are not here as a twin flame to be selfish, to watch videos that resonate with you. You are here as a twin flame, as I do, that give my package out for free, which most are making money that they're leaving their other jobs for, because I make them sell it for at least £100. At least. I don't get jack shit from it. So if you can't go on to another channel and subscribe, like, and watch to the end to raise that person's vibration, go and date a soulmate. We are not here to be selfish. This person wants your person to come over here to keep you happy. You need to be reading my book, which is only in my program. So like I say, the book my program, book my reading, or check out the other two playlists, which kicks ass on anyone on YouTube. They don't have shit like mine. Might be vain, but it's not me. I channel from 5D. So hopefully this has been good for someone. Click on the description now in my description box and like, subscribe my twin sister's channel. And do the work if you bought my program. If not, buy the program. Speak to you later.